Bismillah. Our talk today about foot and ankle joint. First of all, we start with the bones of the foot. We have the phalanges, metatarsals, in addition to seven tarsal bones. These are the pterygoids, calcaneus, navicular, and the cuboid and the cuneiform, three cuneiform bones. And this is an x-ray showing the tarsal and the other foot bones. Starting with the talus, calcaneus, cuboid, navicular, cuneiforms, and the navicular bone, in addition to the metatarsals and the phalanges. First of all, we start with the talus. The long axis that point forward and medially. This is the talus pointing forward and medially and having a body with upper trochlear surface for articulating with the tibia, a head having articulation with the navicular, a neck that having inferior groove that forming the sinus tali. That is with the sinus calcani will form the sinus tarsi, and also having posterior process. This is a comparison between the os trigonum, which is a well-corticated bone fragment posterior to the left talus, and this is an elongated stadial process, also at the posterior aspect of the talus. And this is a Shepard fracture, posterior talar process fracture, that is a vertical lucency through the posterior talar process. Regarding the inferior surface of the talus, we have the large facet posteriorly for articulation with the calcaneus that is called the subtalar or posterior subtalar joint, and the anterior talocalcaneal navicular joint having anteriorly at the top of the head articulation with the navicular and anterior facet for articulation with the calcaneus and another medial facet for articulation with the sustentaculum of the calcaneus. Regarding the calcaneus, it is the largest tarsal bone, having long axis points forward and laterally, and lying under the talus. It is an irregularly cuboidal in shape with shelf-like process called the sustentaculum tali. Plantar surface having large calcaneal tuberosity. This is the large tuberosity posteriorly, having medial and lateral processes or tubercles, with a small peroneal tubercle on the lateral surface. The upper surface having three facets for articulation of the talus. This is the posterior facet, as we said about the posterior subtalar joint, and this is the anterior and medial facet. Regarding the arch of the foot, we have the longitudinal arch, starting with the medial arch that is formed by the calcaneus, talus, three metatarsal, three cuneiforms, and three metatarsal bones that is supported by the plantar fascia. So any prolonged stress on the medial arch can lead to micro tears of the plantar fascia and resulting in plantar fasciitis. Regarding the lateral arch, it is formed by the calcaneus, cuboid, fourth and fifth metatarsal bones. And the transverse arch that is formed by the distal tarsals and the proximal end of metatarsals. Regarding the angle of the longitudinal arch is one of the angles drawn on the weight-bearing lateral foot radiograph, the angle that is formed between the calcaneal inclination axis, this is the calcaneal inclination axis, and the inferior edge of the base of fifth metatarsal. It is about 150 to 170. The angle between the os calcis and the base of the first metatarsal. Here is a bit of a difference in radiobedia. The angle is about 150 to 170. The book is about 115 to 125. The angle is a bit of a difference in reading and also a difference in the angle. The angle exceeds 170. Well, this is the Bisplenus, case of Bisplenus, in which the angle exceeding 170. هو يقيس الكلكينال inclination angle هذا القوس بعدين يرجع ياخذ يعني الانجل مالت الارش. While in Bascavus, this is a case of Bascavus in which the angle below 150 من يصعد الكلكينال inclination angle فحتقل الزاويه مالت الميديال ارش. Regarding the Bohler angle, it is the angle between the posterior articular surface to the anterior articular surface of the calcaneus and another line drawn from the lateral point to the posterior superior of the calcaneus. It is normally about 30 to 35 or 20 to 40. So when it is less than 20 or 28, it is abnormal, Bohler angle. Regarding the heel path thickness, it is the measurement from the posterior superior or the posterior inferior of the calcaneus to the skin surface inferiorly. It is about 21 mm in female while 23 in male. It is increased in acromegaly or gingivitis. We have also the long axis of the talus, which is pointed toward the first metatarsal in old age group, in all children more than 5 years old, and it is more vertical oriented below the first metatarsal in less than 3 years old. This is X-ray for child less than 3 years old, and the talus of vertical orientation below the orientation of the first metatarsal. We have a simple comparison for Jones and pseudo-Jones fracture. This is a Jones fracture at the base of the fifth metatarsal, or called the staggered process of the base of fifth metatarsal, which is a transverse lucency, while pseudo-Jones fracture, or it is an oblique lucency, also at the base of the fifth metatarsal. The Jones fracture, mostly it is an avulsion fracture by the fracture to an oblique orientation. Regarding the sesamoid bones, we have many accessory bones in the foot that are called the sesamoids. The most common sesamoid is the sesamoid at the metatarsophalangeal joint of the hallux, or the first toe, at the tendon of the flexor hallucis brevis. Also, we have another sesamoid joints. Also, we have the os vesalianum at the base of the fifth metatarsal, also os veronium between the cuboid and the base of the fifth metatarsal, also supratalar, supranavicular, and other sesamoid locations. This is the sesamoid at the flexor hallucis brevis. Then the other side is os vesalianum, os veronium, os trigonum, supratalar, supranavicular, and calcaneal secondaries. Regarding the ossification of bones of the foot, primary ossification centers are present at birth, visible at X-ray from birth. We have the cuboid ossified at birth. The primary ossification center is developing after birth. We have the cuneiforms and the navicular that start ossification from the first to the third year of life. And secondary ossification, metatarsals and phalanges should all be present. But the last secondary ossification center to develop is the calcaneus that appear about 5 years old. This is an X-ray of a child having an accessory ossification center of the calcaneus ossification, and all other tarsal bones starting with one ossification center. Regarding the coalition of bones of the foot, coalition is abnormal fusion between two or more tarsal bones and is a frequent cause of pain. It is 90% involving the talocalcaneal or calcaneonavicular joints. It is either pain developing the second decade as bone growth is impaired and abnormal segment becomes mineralized. And this is an example of the talocalcaneal and calcaneonavicular. This is talocalcaneal C-shaped coalition, as you see, and this is calcaneonavicular coalition. Regarding the ankle joint, it is a synovial hang joint. طبعا معنى hang joint طلعتها انه هي يعني غالبا الجوينت يتحرك بمحور واحد او يعني flexion plant يعني plant flexion. The other examples of hang joint هي the knee joint, the elbow and the interphalangeal joints. Regarding the articular surfaces of the knee joint, عفوا of the ankle joint, we have the inferior surface of the tibia and the inner aspect of the medial malleolus, the upper trochlear surface of the talus that is wider anteriorly than posteriorly that make it more stable in dorsiflexion. Regarding the capsule, it is attached to the margin of the articular surfaces, except where it extends distally to the neck of the talus. This is a plane radiograph showing the ankle joint. The tibiotalar surfaces should be parallel to each other and perpendicular to the shaft of the tibia. Articular surfaces of the malleoli on each side are symmetrical. As you see, this is symmetrical and with the lateral malleolus being more the surface of the tibia. This is an AB view of the ankle joint. As you see, this is the tibia, the fibula, the ankle mortis. طبعا الانكل مورتس القصد من عنده انه هذا البراكت شيب مورتس اللي يكون غالبا يعني معنى مورتس انه حسب من ضمن كافيتي او ضمن ريسس يسموه انكل مورتس يعني يسموه مثل قفل فيعتبروا هذا يعني المورتس بالنسبه للانكل جوينت. This is the lateral malleolus, the medial and the talus bone. This is the lateral X-ray for the ankle joint showing the tibia, fibula, talus and the calcaneus, and this is the ankle joint. This is an oblique radiographs in addition to the AB view. This is AB view. And this is the mortis view. شوية ياخذ internal rotation 15-20 درجة يعني internal rotation على مود بس يراويني الميديال واللاترال joint spaces حتى اشوف الجوينت سبيسز. لأنه أنا بالAB ما راح اشوف الجوينت سبيسز بشكل واضح. بالinternal rotation شوية راح أقدر أشوف أحصر open. بالنسبة لل 45 oblique view شوية راح آخذ internal rotation أكثر من المورتس view. راح أروح 45 درجة oblique view حتى أفتح الديستال يعني هذا inferior عفوا. Distal inferior tibiofibular joint. هذا الdistal inferior tibiofibular أو inferior tibiofibular joint حقدر أشوفه بشكل واضح. Regarding the external oblique trauma, ممكن ناخذ يعني غير الانترنال يعني other view هو الاكسترنال اوبليك حتى اشوف يعني في حاله التروما في حاله الفراكشرز البوستير مالولار فراكشر او تراي مالولار فراكشرز اذا اكو اي فيوجن اي other problem can be seen by this view. This is the gravity ولا يعني بحكم الجرافيتي راح نستخدمها او مانو ستريس راح نستخدم الستريتشنج باند وهذا هو الفيو غالبا هنا يعني اذا اكو اي joint space abnormality اي loss of parallelism اي يعني انه اي ligament مال يعني مال alignment او شيء راح يبين بالنسبه للjoint space راح يكون وايد in joint space. And this is example of trimalular fracture. As you see, this is the fracture of the lateral medial malleolus and the posterior malleolus, and this is a masonic fracture chin and other fracture of the fibula. Regarding the arthrograph, the synovial cavity is outlined by injection of contrast. And then we contrast the anterior aspect of the knee of the ankle joint, just medial the tibialis anterior tendon or medial the flexor to the extensor hallucis longus tendon. And the articles or the other structures can be seen by the arthrograph. We have also other normal findings, swelling of the synovium around the tendons of flexor hallucis longus or the flexor digitorum longus, both are fold in 20% of arthrograms, and the posterior subtalar joint is fold in 10%, and this is considered normal. Any other extravasation considered abnormal. And this is صورة للأرثروغرام.
بس ارجع ارجع يا بابا ارجع هاي الصورة شنو؟ هاي واحد وهاي واحد
هذا الانجكشن اللي يعني هنا يعني مطلع نيدل الانجكشن مالت الكونتراست
وهنا
كونتراست انجكشن
بابا شنو هاي؟ امار اريثرو هذا امار اريثرو
امار اريثروغرام نعم يبلي هو بداية يحقن كونتراست بعدين يحقن امار اريثروغرام امار اريثروغرام
نعم
بلي بلي امار اريثروغرام نعم Regarding the ultrasound on the ankle joints, we can examine the tendons. Here we have the tibialis anterior tendon, and other tendons can be examined by ultrasound of the ankle joint between the fibula and the talus. We have the talofibular ligaments can be examined by ultrasound. The calcaneofibular ligaments. Any discontinuity, طبعاً هي غالباً تكون يعني hypoechoic وأي يعني أي signal abnormality أي أو إنه أو أي تغيير بال يعني بالنسبة للsignal أو بالecogenicity أو any يعني discontinuity can be examined by ultrasound. Regarding the CT, we can have 2 mm thick slices, axial and coronal views to assess the bony components of the ankle. We have the talus, calcaneus, cuboid, and the next issue, the talus, the calcaneus, the sesadeculum, we have the medial malleolus and the lateral malleolus. Regarding the MRI, we can examine the soft tissues, especially ligaments and tendons. We have a variety of sequences that can be used for examining of the ankle joint. طبعا واحده من استخدامات الام ار اي بالنسبه للانكل جوينت هي يعني هو الفحص مالت التندنز كلش مهم خاصه هذا الفيو يعني هنا يبين الاكستنسر تندنز والبيرونيال تندنز والفلكسر بالنسبه للاكستنسر تندنز وي هاف فيرست اوف اول ذا تيبيالس انتيرير تندن اند اكستنسر هالوسز لونجوس تندن اكستنسر ديجيتورم لونجوس تندن طبعا كل ذني يفوتن تحت الاكستنسر تيناكيلم وعندنا هنا البيرونيال اللي هنا تكون لاترال كومبارتمنت وي هاف ذا بيرونيوس سبليدز انتيريرلي اند بيرونيوس لونجوس تندن بوستيريرلي وي هاف ذا فلكسر تندنز طبعا هنا تكون يعني تحت البيرونيال retinaculum. بالنسبه للفلكسر تندنز عندنا تيبيالس بوستيرير فيرست اوف اول فلكسر ديجيتورم لونجوس تندن اند بوستيريرلي وي هاف ذا فلكسر هالوسز تندن اور ذا اكليس تندن هنا انا في الصوره تبين الريتيناكيلم وي هاف ذا سوبيرير اند انفيرير ريتيناكيلم ذا فلكسر ريتيناكيلم اند ذا بيرونيال ريتيناكيلم ذا لاترال ريتيناكيلم Regarding the relevant MRI anatomy, 4 major ligamental stabilizers in the foot and ankle, including the lateral collateral ligament, the medial collateral ligament, the deltoid ligament, the syndesmotic complex, and the interosseous ligament, the telecalcaneal ligament, and the sinus tarsal. The lateral collateral ligament to provide lateral stability and 5 components. First of all, we have the anterior telefibular. This is the anterior telefibular ligament, posterior telefibular ligament, calcaneofibular, tibio, anterior tibiofibular, and the posterior tibiofibular ligament. First of all, we start with the anterior telefibular ligament that is shown in the axial plane running anterior medially from the tip of the lateral malleolus to the anterior lateral aspect of the talus. That is homogeneously hypointense in all sequences. This is axial MRI showing the anterior telefibular ligament that is hypointense in signal. The injury can lead to hemorrhage signal, ligamentous swelling, signal of normality and often with incomplete tear, while complete rupture can lead to retraction and always accompanied by joint fusion and leakage to the surrounding soft tissues. Then the calcaneofibular ligament, this is the calcaneofibular ligament, visualizing the axial oblique perpendicular to the posterior subtalar joint or the axial plane, a spine linear structure that is deep to the peroneal tendons and hypointense in all sequences after injury also can lead to hemorrhage, edema, swelling, signal of normality. But communication with the peroneal tendon sheath can result in frequently associated tendon sheath fluid and occasional subluxation. طبعا هذا ممكن يسوي connection with the peroneal sheath اللي هي او the peroneal tendons اللي تكون more superficial. This is the calcaneofibular ligament inserted on the calcaneal peroneal tubercle, and this is the spring or the tibial spring ligament. Regarding the posterior telefibular ligament, this is a fan shape. This is the posterior telefibular ligament identified on the same image of the same section of the anterior telos, showing the both posterior telefibular and the anterior telefibular are the same section. This is running from the malleolar fossa. This is the malleolar fossa on the inner aspect of the lateral malleolus to the posterior tibial tubercle on the calcaneus, and it's extremely strong and rarely injured as it is fan shaped. Regarding the medial collateral ligament, we have the deltoid ligament that having 5 components. First of all, we have the anterior tibial tibiocalcaneal tibionavicular and tibiospring. This is classically divided to superficial layer arising from the anterior of the medial malleolus and branching to the navicular calcaneus and talus, and a deep layer from the posterior of the medial malleolus to the medial of the talus. Injury to deltoid can lead can occur in complex trauma, often associated with injury to the lateral collateral ligament of the syndesmus. غالبا the medial collateral ligament rarely إنه يروح على medial collateral. وغالبا إذا صار medial collateral injury فهو غالبا accompanied with lateral collateral or the syndesmotic injury. This is a coronal section MRI showing the deep deltoid layer, and this is the superficial layer that is seen in multiple sections or multiple oblique views. This is the deep and the superficial deltoid layers. Regarding the syndesmosis, we have three stabilizing components of the inferior tibiofibular articulation. We have the inferior tibiofibular ligament, posterior tibiofibular, and the interosseous membrane. Injury to syndesmosis is extremely uncommon in the absence of fracture. غالبا الفراكشر يلا يصير injury to syndesmosis. طبعا بالنسبه لل section just proximal للتيبيوتيلر articulation. فقبل التيبيوتيلر articulation راح اشوف التيبيوفيبولار ligaments. And injury to syndesmosis usually involving rupture to the anterior tibiofibular and sparing of the posterior tibiofibular. هذا الانتيرو تيبيوفيبولار راح يمتد من الانتيرو تيبيوفيبولار للتيبيا laterally to the tibia, at the anterior margin joint or articulation. And the posterior tibiofibular ligament extending from the tibia also laterally to the tibia at the posterior margin of the tibiofibular articulation. طبعا اثنيناتهم نشوفهم proximal للتيبيوتيلر articulation. الانجري rupture to the posterior tibiofibular. The posterior is stronger and therefore when stressed resulting in a bulging fracture of the insertion rather than soft tissue rupture. Regarding the ligaments of the sinus tarsalis, the sinus tarsalis has a cone-shaped space between the inferolateral of the talus and the superolateral of the calcaneus, having multiple ligaments and multiple nerves and also predominant with fat. Hospital without surgical intervention, although scarring present laxity can result in instability. And minor inversion or reversion injury can lead to hemorrhage, edema, and neurovascular compression or even ligamentous disruption and subtalar dislocation. The ligaments in the intraosseous talocalcaneal ligaments and the foot of the inferior extensor retinaculum, all of these in the sinus tarsalis. This is sagittal MRI showing the sinus tarsi with the interosseous telecalcaneal ligaments. This is the telecalcaneal ligaments, and this is the fat contained within the sinus tarsi. And this is the calcaneus, this is the cuboid, this is the navicular bone, and the cuneiforms. We have also the tarsal tunnel. Tarsal tunnel, this is a narrow tunnel at the inferior compartment just around the neurovascular bundle. This tunnel is composed, first of all, then the flexor of the digitorum longus, then the neurovascular bundle, and ending with the flexor hallucis longus. So any lesion in this narrow tunnel can lead to compression on the neurovascular bundle. This is a case of 22 years old male with burning sensation of the ankle on MRI, T2 MRI, resulting in hyperintense ganglion cyst that causing compression on the tibial nerve. Regarding the Bingman syndromes, the anterolateral Bingman syndrome, first of all, we have the anterolateral Bingman syndrome that is called the foot waller ankle, which is a bent folder's affliction. It's a soft tissue impingement with associated pain between anterolateral osseous structures of the ankle joint, the lateral getter. Most commonly fibrous overgrowth of synovitis following chronic tear of the anterior telefibular ligament. غالبا الانتيرو تلفيبولار اللي حيكون anteriorly هو اللي حيكون affected, واللي غالبا بعد الكرونيك تير هو اللي يؤدي الى الانتيرولاترال Bingman syndrome. This is an X-ray and MRI sections showing the anterior Bingman syndrome. This is by accessory bone or sesamoid bone causing impingement syndrome anteriorly. We have also the syndesmotic type impingement syndrome, the acute pain when soft tissue impinging between osseous structures of the syndesmosis that manifests as thickening and synovitis at the site of chronic tear of the anterior tibiofibular ligaments. غالبا هنا the joint اللي affected حيكون هو anterior tibiofibular ligaments. This multiple sections shown on this X-ray showing the syndesmotic type impingement syndrome. Regarding the posterior impingement, this describes the impingement of posterior soft tissue structures between posterolateral osseous structures. In most cases, the syndrome reflects the impingement of the impingement of the hypertrophied posterior inferior tibiofibular ligament or the posterior intermalular fracture, mostly caused by the extreme plantar flexion mechanism. This is a posterior impingement. This is a prominent lateral talar tubercle. As we said, this is the seed tubercle process posteriorly from the talus bone and causing focal thickening of the posterior capsule. Regarding the tendons, first of all, we have by the merging of the gastrocnemius and the soleus tendons that extend inferiorly to insert on the dorsum of the calcaneus. Can be visualized by ultrasound, also by the sagittal MRI. Also, this is another section for sagittal MRI showing the Achilles tendon. Any injury can occur either at the insertion to the calcaneus or at the muscular tendinous junction just proximal to the insertion. This is an X-ray showing the Kegel's normal fat pad that can be obturated in case of any injury to the ligament or any joint effusion. This is the triangle of Kegel's fat pad that can be obturated in trauma. Regarding the peroneal tendons, the peroneal muscle belly is within the lateral compartment. هذني طبعا عندنا tendons مات البيرونيال يعني البيرونيال مصر اللي we have the peroneus brevis tendon that runs from or posterior to the fibular groove of the lateral manulus on the lateral of the foot to insert on the base of the metatarsal, while the peroneus limbus that come to lie under the cuboid bone then insert to the medial cuneiform and the first metatarsal. Injury to the peroneus brevis is more common than longus due to laxity of the superior peroneal retinaculum that allow superior peroneal lags with resulting tendinitis. Regarding the tibialis posterior, this is a muscle of posterior compartment of the calf that run behind the lateral manulus and come to insert to the navicular to the basals 2-4. This is the major support for the medial longitudinal arch during the planted foot phase of the gait cycle and responsible for both plantar flexion and inversion. So acute injuries to the tibialis posterior by forced dorsiflexion with the chronic overuse or trauma in the middle-aged females. Chronic tear can result in collapse of the medial arch or required flat foot with progressive hindgut valgus and resulting in subtalar joint stabilization or arthritis. granted, the hallux flexor hallucis longus, this is the dominant flexor inverter of the foot with extensive course to insert to the distal or the base of the distal phalanx alligator. The injury the flexor hallucis longus either proximal at the site of the medial malleolus in chronic overuse or injury at the muscular tendinous junction, this is the muscular tendinous junction in ballet dancers, or occur distally at the toe when attempting to pick a ball into this is called the turf toe. Again, the tibialis anterior tendon, this is the muscle of the anterior calf compartment. The tendon comes to insert on the medial cuneiform on the base of the pars metatarsal. This is the dominant flexor inverter of the foot, an injury induced by trauma, either acute by force extension and inversion, and most cases rupture is a sequel of chronic trauma with repeated encroachment of the tendon by the extensor retinaculum over time. This is axial MRI showing the multiple tendons, common tendons that we say this is the tendon of tibialis anterior, then the extensor hallucis longus tendon, and this is the extensor digitorum longus tendon, and the peroneus tertius, all of this in the extensor compartment, and we have the peroneal compartment, this is the peroneus longus tendon, and the flexor compartment, we have the tibialis posterior, more medially than the flexor digitorum longus, then the flexor hallucis longus posteriorly, and we have the neuromuscular bundle, more medial, and this is the soleus and the Achilles tendon. Again, the osteogonum syndrome, the osteogonum represent congenital and unilateral tubercle of the posterior process of the talus. During flexion extension, synovial tissue may interdigitate between it and the posterior tibia, resulting in capsular interrupt, local pain, inflammation, inflammatory changes can be seen in the sagittal MRI. This is the osteogonum and the embigment of the soft tissues between the sesamoid bone and the tibia. Regarding the subtalar joint, this is a synovial joint responsible for inversion and inversion of the foot. It's involving three subtalar facets. As we said, this is the posterior subtalar joint, and another three facets for articulation with the calcaneus. Anteriorly, we have the anterior facet for articulation with the calcaneus, and medial facet for articulation with the sesamoideum tali of calcaneus, and another facet at the top of the head of the talus for articulation with the navicular. Regarding the vein radiograph of the subtalar joint, oblique views can show the subtalar joint. This is normal subtalar joint with foot in internal rotated 45 degree and film exposure in 10, 20, 30, and 40 degrees for complete visualizing the joint. This is a normal subtalar joint, and this is an abnormal subtalar joint. Regarding CT of subtalar joint, to examine the articular facets of the subtalar joints, we have the posterior articular facet, the middle facet, and the anterior articulation. Also, we can examine the subtalar joint by MRI. This is anterior and posterior subtalar, also showing the sinus tarsi. Other joints, we have also the intertarsal joint. This is the intertarsal or the metatarsal joint that is called the chopper joint. And we have also the tarsometatarsal joint that is called the Lisfranc joint. And also we have the metatarsophalangeal joint and the interphalangeal joint. All of these synovial joints. This is an example of the normal Lisfranc joint. As we say, this is the tarsometatarsal joint, normal. And this is the displaced Lisfranc joint fracture. This is called Lisfranc joint according to the Lisfranc injury or Lisfranc fracture. And this is the metatarsal or intertarsal joint with Chobart fracture. And so it is called the Chobart joint, the intertarsal joint. An intertarsal Chobart joint between the calcaneus and the navicular, and the calcaneus and the cuboid laterally, talus and navicular medially. And خلصت عمي إذا أكو أي question.
شتيدي دكتورة فاتن طبعا very important subject هو هذا الانكل والفوت هو nice presentation والشرح والهذي بس اكو باللي قمن شادي مال الفوت اكو مقاطع توضيحية ما ضايفتها انتي على التندنس اللي انتيرير كما يقسموها لان اذا قدرين تضيفيها هو يصير دياجرام توضيحي
والله عم هواية دي قد صور يعني على التندنس بس قدرت خاف يصير عليهم هواية يعني
لا بس واحدة توضيحية هذه تراويهم الانتيرير تيبياليش والبوستيرير انه بها ثري
واضح راح ادورها
اكو احد عنده سؤال قبل ما نروح على الكويز تايم يا شباب
طبعا انا اعتذر حاولت استعجل قدر الامكان حتى اختصر الوقت
بالعكس هم مراج لازم يقروها ويقروها زين وعلى كيفهم وهذه هو هاي شو اسمه التقديم الصحيح انه واحد يسوي كفر والباقي الطلاب منه يخلص باله مو مجرد يسمعها ويعوفها وهذه وهو قارئ قبلها حتى يكون اكو شغلات ما منتبه عليها ما مأكد عليها من يسمعها تبقى باله ماكو سؤال اذا ماكو سؤال اذا نروح على الكويز تايم يلا توكلي على الله نبدي
بروسل الاراضي of ankle joint and foot lateral or AB view الA fibula
A fibula اوكي سيزار
عمي الB lateral
malleolus اللي هي الديستال اند مالت الفيبيولا على عبد الرزاق
سي مورتس
المورتس اللي تمثل لنا هي التيبيو تالس
تالس
عنده علي محمد رضا
دي تالس بون
تالس بون اوكي دعاء علي ولا رافع
الاي هو الميديال مانيولس.
ميديال مانيولس اكسلنت. افران
يا عمي الاف التيبيا.
الاف اللي هو التيبيا. which part of the tibia؟
الشافت.
اكو اي يعني
يعني
الانفس يعتبروا اوكي. هند هادي
البوستيريور مالولس.
الدي بوستيريور مالولس اوكي. عندنا لانشة
ايش هو ليفت كالكينيوم.
كالكينيوم بالضبط. عندنا ورا لانشة صفا عدي.
عندنا اي نافيكولار بون.
نافيكولار بون. شو رأي ساعدي؟
الجي هو الكيونيفورم بون.
الكيونيفورم بون. اسماء خزعل.
نعم استاذ. الكي كيوبويد بون.
كيوبويد بون. ليش يسرحوا لك كيوبويد؟
لأنه لاترال.
مكعب.
يعني لو الشيء ما في شيء مكعب.
فت عندنا أسيل كريم. الأل.
فيفث ميتاتارسل. البيس مالتها.
بيس. مين يتشلب بيها؟ يا تندر.
ال هو عندنا إكستنسر. الإكستنسر ديجيتال لونجاس.
لا.
هاي اللي قبل. ممكن يوصلها.
سير أفالشن فراكشر. سير أفالشن فراكشر.
بيرونيوس.
البرينيوس
لونجاس وين
تشيل الفيرست راح من الفيبيولا لاترالي وميديالي وبعدين تلوف تروح على يعني لاترالي
انسرشن الفيفث البيرونيوس بريفيس اوكي بعدك هو
بعد على اخر واحد اخر
اكزامبل استاذ محمد
اه عين
سلام عيني
وميض الاي عمي هاي اللي اكستنسر ديجيتورم اذا اني
يا لسنتير
العي اكس
العي
لا هاي
هو هذا يقول لك اكزي الامراي يا لسنتير
اكستنسر هاليسس لونجس
زين ابو خضير
نعم ال ال الاي اللي هو البوستيرال تيبياليس الميديال تندر الميديال كومبارتمنت سي نعم
سي
لحظه السي هو السي هو الفلكسر هالسز لونجاس
حسين حمود دي العفو استاذ دي الفلكسر هالسز
لونجاس دكتور
مينا
نعم استاذ نعم تيبيال بوستيريور تندن تيبيال